Dear friends, in the previous videos on the same topic, magnetic effects of electric current, we have seen that for a straight current carrying conductor, a magnetic field is set up around it. The Hans Christian Oersted's observation that a current carrying conductor behaves like a magnet, and we have done the activity also to establish that magnetic field arranges or aligns itself in a plane perpendicular to the current carrying conductor, and there will be field around it in form of concentric circles. The same straight conductor, if we bend it in form of a loop and there is electric current, then each part of this loop contributes to magnetic field, and ultimately the field intensity at the core or at the center of loop carrying current is strong. Also, we learned that if a current in a loop is in clockwise direction, then the one that faces us is the south pole, and if in the loop the direction of current is anti-clockwise, then the one that faces us is north pole and behind is south pole. That means when current is in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, these single loops behave as or display that pair property. That means it will have the pair of poles. Then if a single loop carrying current behaves like a slice of a bar magnet, then what about having a number of loops together, or having a conductor that is wound in form of a coil and passing electric current through it? Then in such a case, each loop contributes to magnetic field, and since field intensity in the core is more, every loop, when they contribute to field, the total field strength due to such a winding or such a coil will be more. That means compared to straight current carrying conductor, magnetic field strength will be more in such an arrangement. This kind of an arrangement, which we get by winding insulated copper wire over a hollow cardboard cylinder or any, say, a soft iron or a steel, a cylindrical form, so that every loop diameter is same. So such kind of a coil arrangement that we get by winding insulated copper wire over a cylindrical object and passing electric current through that, such an arrangement is called a solenoid. So what is a solenoid? Solenoid is made out of insulated copper wire that is wound over a hollow cardboard cylinder, having a number of turns such that its length is greater than its diameter. So length should be greater than diameter. Such a coil arrangement of insulated copper wire is called a solenoid. Now, when in such a arrangement, which is called a solenoid, electric current is made to pass, every slice displays the pair property. Clockwise means south pole, behind north pole. Anti-clockwise means front face is north pole and behind is south pole. So every loop behaves like a slice of bar magnet. Then what about when we have this many slices of bar magnet together, will definitely behave like a bar magnet. So a current carrying solenoid will behave like a bar magnet. Behave like bar magnet means it will display all the properties of a bar magnet. So finally, a straight current carrying conductor behaves like a magnet, and the same conductor, if it is wound in form of a coil, that behaves like a bar magnet. Why? Because every loop has got its two faces with two poles. That means every loop displays that pair property, and so many slices of bar magnets together, or so many loops which display pair property, ultimately give us a complete bar magnet, right? So I have redrawn the diagram of a solenoid. How to define a solenoid? A solenoid is made up of insulated copper wire. That means a solenoid is made up of an insulated copper wire that is wound over a hollow cardboard cylinder having a number of turns, means coil has, the insulated copper wire has number of turns, having a number of turns such that its length is more than its diameter. If length is more, then every additional coil that is added to increase its length adds to the magnetic field. And the diameter should be less. Less the diameter, stronger the field in the core. Now quickly I discuss the properties of a magnetic field and its lines of forces due to a solenoid carrying current. So there is a simple circuit. There is a variable resistor, a battery of cells and a closed plug key. So when the circuit is closed, and by varying resistance, we can vary current in the solenoid. When we vary current, we will see that when there is more current in the solenoid, a stronger field is achieved. That means magnetic field strength due to solenoid directly depends upon the magnitude of current. Magnetic field strength due to a current carrying solenoid depends upon the number of turns of the insulated copper wire. Means every new turn that is added, or every new loop added to the arrangement, that adds enough amount of magnetic field intensity or increases field strength. That magnetic field strength is inversely proportional to the diameter of the solenoid. Less the diameter, stronger the field. And since each of these coil or loops or the solenoid itself is made by winding insulated copper wire over hollow cardboard cylinder. Cardboard means that will give each loop the same diameter. So there is no loss of field. See, what I mean is, say if the coil is wound something like this, and then we close the circuit, we pass electric current, then whatever field is created by this, that will improve the intensity. But whatever field is created here or here, that much amount of magnetic field goes waste. So there is a loss of energy. But if the coil is wound over hollow cardboard cylinder, that uniformity increases the field strength in the core. So the field strength in the core will be more compared to field strength outside. And since it behaves like a bar magnet, the lines of forces pattern also will be same as that of bar magnet. See friends, here the current direction is clockwise. And if current direction is clockwise, the one that is facing us to the left side, from left side if you see the solenoid, this will be south pole. In that case, from right side when we see, the right end is north pole. So it has a pole, so it is a bar magnet. Next, since all the loops are of same diameter, field is uniform inside, and the field lines, this is a property actually, the magnetic field is uniform in the core of a solenoid. Its meaning is the magnetic field lines are parallel lines in the core, and the field pattern is just like the way we have seen for a bar magnet. So what are the properties of magnetic field lines of force? The properties of lines of forces due to solenoid: field is uniform in the core, so field lines are parallel inside the core, field intensity is more in the core, and outside it is less. And magnetic field is in form of, the pattern of magnetic field is very similar to the field pattern of a bar magnet. So finally, solenoid behaves like a bar magnet, and magnetic lines of forces inside the core of solenoid are parallel lines. Why parallel lines? Why? Because every loop is of same diameter, and field is uniform, and uniform fields diagram is parallel lines. Then lines of forces are always directed north to south outside and south to north inside. Friends, this activity is a laboratory activity. If you punch a cardboard along the axis of solenoid, then we will see that all the lines of forces in the axis is parallel lines. that means lines of forces in the core of solenoid will be parallel lines, and we can even sometimes take a compass needle also, which will be from north to south outside, and the arrow of the compass needle will direct us south to north inside. That will be a great activity. And then finally, these all we have discussed. Field strength depends upon these factors.